Hello students, today we are going to study detection of cation, and for detection of cations we have taken three salt solution. This is ferrous sulfate, this is ferric chloride and this is copper sulfate solution. Now suppose I have given you unknown salt solution and I ask you to detect cations right from this salt solution. So how will you do it? So for that we need two reagents. One is sodium hydroxide solution and another reagent is ammonium hydroxide solution, right? So what we have to do is we have to take two test tubes, right? So when you take these two test tubes, all of you, and we will be taking in this test tube, in both the test tube we will take ferrous sulfate solution and which is light green in color. So we will be taking ferrous sulfate solution in both this test tube. Now in one test tube we will be adding NaOH and in another test tube we will be adding NH4OH. So if we add in the first test tube NaOH, sodium hydroxide, in little amount you have to add. So when you add it in little amount we are getting dirty green precipitate, right? So this dirty green precipitate on adding, now in excess also we have to observe. So two observations: in little amount when you add NaOH, dirty green precipitate, and on adding excess we are again seeing the same thing, it is dirty green precipitate and the precipitate is insoluble in excess, right? Now in the second test tube we will see that this salt solution is ferrous sulfate, only add little amount of ammonium hydroxide. Now when you add little amount of ammonium hydroxide, here also you will see it's dirty green precipitate. Now on adding excess of ammonium hydroxide we will see that precipitate remains as it is, that means it is insoluble. So this is ammonium hydroxide and this is with sodium hydroxide. So this confirms that the salt solution has ferrous as cation. Now we will be taking another two test tubes to detect second salt solution, and in that we will be taking ferric chloride. Now we will take ferric chloride here in both this. So see here, two salt solutions are taken. The salt solution is the same, but in two test tube we are taking the salt solution. Now in first test tube we will add NaOH, okay? So when you add little NaOH we will see it is reddish brown precipitate, okay? See here, we got precipitate. Precipitate is an insoluble solid, and on adding excess of sodium hydroxide PPT remains as it is. See, all these which I am demonstrating right now are precipitation reaction. Precipitation reaction means the reactants must be in aqueous state and one of the products is insoluble. Now in the second test tube we will add NH4OH. So always remember, in first test tube NaOH in little and excess, and in second test tube NH4OH in little. See, reddish brown PPT. Now it is ferric is confirmed when it is reddish brown PPT, and on adding excess it is insoluble. So see, in both these cases we are getting reddish brown PPT, and now it confirms that it is ferric, okay, as cation, right? Now let us understand the second one, all of you. So here in this we are taking copper sulfate solution, okay, which is blue in color. So we have taken copper sulfate solution, look at this. Now what we will do, again the same way we will be doing, we will add little of NaOH. So very little amount of NaOH we'll add, and we will see here we are getting pale blue precipitate. Now on adding excess of NaOH the PPT remains as it is, okay, pale blue PPT, and it is as it is, okay. Now let us take another test tube, and in this we will add in little of NH4OH, very little you add, otherwise you will see that, see here we are getting, what is this, pale blue precipitate. And now when you add excess of NH4OH you see what happens, it's very beautiful color we will be getting. See here, this is an inky blue solution form, PPT is dissolved. See, I'll shake it, we will see that it is a very clear solution, inky blue solution. This is tetraamine copper sulfate. Here cupric hydroxide is soluble on adding excess of NH4OH. So when I am adding excess of NH4OH, cupric hydroxide, pale blue PPT is soluble, and I am getting an inky blue, you can say, deep blue you can say, or you can say violet. It is tetraamine copper sulfate, a complex soluble salt is formed. See the difference between these two, with NaOH and this is with NH4OH. So by this we can confirm that the salt solution is copper sulfate, or you can say the cation present in the salt solution is cupric. So on doing this, we confirmed all these by color of the precipitate, we confirmed that these are the cations. You can see this beautiful colors. Okay. Thank you, students.